Hi, I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy1, and I've been having people ask for this, and so I'm going to go ahead and do it. This is going to be a tutorial on how to trim a cowl, Fisker's sewing shears. And we're going to go ahead, and some of this will be in time lapse, so you can see. We're going to go ahead and cut right on the seam. But the nice benefit of the latex cowls, as I've explained in some of my other videos, is that the stretchability, but the ability to hold its shape. This is now trimmed. Now we have a styrofoam head inside. Just take that out. And basically, I always start with the mouth. And I always do it, the same way. You get a little bit more efficient if you do it the same way. And I poke it in the corner there first, come around. And always make sure when you get to the corner to round it out. Don't do any 90-degree angles. You want all rounds, because if you put any stress points or any cuts, then you're inviting a tear. We don't want to invite a tear. There's certain ways you can tear latex. If you stretch it and you put a razor next to it, yeah, it'll go. Just like with a pin and a balloon. It'll pop it. Put a stress point in it. Now, with the eyes, what I like to do is I like to cut them twice. First, I make sure I go around and get as close as I can, and then I turn them inside out. I actually sculpt my eyes now so that I can get a really good eye every single time. I don't have to make a choice. I have all my cutting lines on there, and so everyone comes out the same. So I try to produce videos and give advice over the years in general, generic senses. Okay, so now I've cut the eyes out, okay? You could just leave it like that. But what I do now is I turn it inside out and I cut it again to make it even better. I've worked long and hard for a quarter of a century to develop some of these basic techniques. So I don't have a lot to share because I did the same thing over and over again a lot of times. That cowl is ready to wear, just like this. Clean it off, get some of the dust from the talcum powder that's inside out. This is one of the big-headed cowls. It's got a little more flexibility than some. See that? It's a little thinner, but it holds its shape. If you're not doing anything to it, it holds its shape. So only if you do anything to it will it move around. So some people really like that. Plasti-Dip's gonna change it. It's gonna make it a little bit less, depending on how much you put on. Now, step number two, bonus. I got a little talcum powder on this, and I'm not gonna do the whole thing in Plasti-Dip, but I'm gonna show you how to do it. You need one of these cheap little chip brushes, your good old trusty Plasti-Dip. By the way, there was an argument like 20 years ago about that it'll peel off. It doesn't peel off if you do it right. I'm gonna show you how to do it right. Okay, so your secret now is this can oxidize, and also, this will help you to get some of the imperfections. Now, a cowl like this, everything's perfect every time. Except I got a little tip of the ear that needs to be fixed. I can fix that. I would fix that first generally, but right now I'm just doing this demonstration. I have a cowl over here that I've already done. I'll show you what it looks like when it's done. Now I'm going to show you how to do the plastic dipping technique. Okay? So basically, what people tend to do is just spray like crazy and gunk it on. That could actually peel if you get, because you have a different body of a certain flexibility of the cowl itself, a certain flexibility of this, and they're constantly pushing at each other. Wherever there's a stress point, yeah, it could peel off. So you don't want to do that. You want to minimize it. One of the ways I minimize it is to go in light, very, very, very light, like this. But then with this cowl that has texture and detail, once you do that, you take the brush really quick and work it in there. No technique about it. You just want to force it into the grooves, and you want to force it off the top of all the surfaces. And the same thing. I try to treat one area at a time. There it is. Basically, get it down in there, take up any excess. The reason why you want to take excess up, especially on a cowl that has texture, is you want all the texture to be seen. And I'm not going to do this whole cowl because I got one over here to show you, but I'm going to show you the basic technique. There you go. Don't even have to look at it, it's so easy. It's only this easy because I've done it a million different ways, and I've found everything that fails, and thusly, just like Thomas Edison with the light bulb, I found it, what succeeds. So this is it. I'm giving you the what succeeds. Now, this side, and that side are done. But there's another step. All right, so this side, and this side are done. But there's another technique. That's still matte finish. And that's fine, because in the movie, really, it is really that, right? But some people like a little more glossier look. And this will help with uniformity as well. You take a regular old rag, mineral spirits, put a little bit on the rag, and you go around it. This will shine it up, and it'll make it all uniform. Now, you probably can't see the sheen. It's just a slight sheen. But that's the final technique. Actually, this is looking a little bit matty. I probably would want to put a little bit more on there to get more of a sheen. If you really gunk it up, it'll get more of a sheen, because what you'll be doing is you'll be slightly melting the plasti dip when you're doing it. Let me do one where there's a lot. There's a lot in one area now, okay? I'm going to put it on there, and I'm going to do this treatment. You get a lot in one area, you're going to get a shine. And especially when you're all done, if you want to, you can armor all it. You can give you more of a shine. Now, that's it. Here's one that's already done. And, you know, we're looking at, what did it take me? A few minutes to trim the cowl? And maybe 5 to 10 minutes to uniformly treat this and rub it down. And there you go. Now, this looks, for all intents and purposes, like a urethane cowl. It's got the sheen. It's got the perfect surface. Everything's perfect. Well, we just spent that extra 15 minutes or so. Well, what have we benefited by this? We've benefited because, let me take this. We've benefited because what we have is latex, but it looks like urethane. We have all the properties of latex. We don't worry about ripping. We have a nice flexibility, but the holding the shape. Remember, this is the big-headed cowl, so it's slightly thinner. Normally, this would be not as flexible until you get the plastic dip on it. That'll make a little bit of the flexibility go away. But we've got the best of both worlds, and that's why for the past 25 years I've been doing this. It takes a little more time, a little more labor of love, but you get the best of both worlds when you're done. And that's why I've insisted on doing it this way. That's another reason why people don't want to do it. Now I'm going to say this, and I don't care. When it takes me a week to make one cowl with latex, and it takes overnight to do a urethane, what I just hate hearing about all the time is people get a urethane cowl, and then it gets ruined on them. They've got nothing then. So as far as I'm concerned, that's a problem. Just is. Anyway, there is my cowl demonstration of trimming and painting. Paul Roberts, Artsy One.